everyone. I am Tony Mendoza, the Senior Director of IT at Spectra Logic. I know this is the last presentation of the day. I'll try to go fast, but it's a pretty fun story to listen to. We made a decision to share our story. We were victims of a ransomware attack in 2020, and we decided to go public with it so we can share our experience, hopefully help somebody, hopefully protect somebody's business, and then use this as a resource. So I'm here to tell you guys a story about what happened to us, and I want to walk you through what it was like to experience a ransomware attack. So this is, you got to remember back, this is May of 2020, right when the pandemic has hit, and right when we, as a company, were trying to decide how to keep our workforce working and effective without having them come into the office. And so we moved remote very quickly. And as we know now, 2 years later, ransomware attacks went up over COVID. We were one of the first ones attacked, and we got to be a statistic. So we find this note, and it's almost comical. I mean, it's just a text message that we found where our file should be, along with an encrypted file of our files. And this is just a quick clip of it. It's like I said, I read it and kind of scoffed at it and said, yeah, this can't be real. I don't know what this is. But then we started finding them everywhere. We're finding them on all of our file servers. We're finding them on our database servers. And it's spreading, like I said. So the next thing we do is, in panic, run to my data center, and we start shutting systems down, unplugging network cables, getting them quarantined, because it's spreading faster than we could talk about it. It's spreading faster than we could investigate systems. So we go pull plugs. And this is, remember, this is a Thursday morning, beginning of a work day, and we're a very transactional company. We do lots of transactions an hour. So any downtime is very detrimental to us. This brought our entire business to its knees. That first day, all we did that day was assess what the damage was. And all we could do, and this is horrible, is bring a system up in quarantine, watch the virus start taking over again, and go, okay, this system is nothing anymore. It's garbage. And so we brought up systems one at a time, quarantined them, put tools in place, did some monitoring to them. One of the only systems that came back up was our email server. And that was a saving grace, but this is not the first day. First day, we go through all our systems, find out they're dead, and one of my peers in the industry said, hey, call the FBI, which I never thought of. I didn't even know how to call the FBI. I had to look up how to call the FBI, and so I'm on the phone with the FBI, and it's like an awkward 911 call. I say, hey, I've had a cybersecurity incident, and instantly they put me through to a cybersecurity agent. We get assigned a field agent, and beyond the panic of that first day, that was kind of cool. Here's what else we figured out. With all the encryption and all the different ransoms that they wanted, they asked for $3.6 million in Bitcoin in 5 days. So naturally, that's not something that anyone keeps laying around. What we did confirm in all this was the way it spread the quickest through our network was through our backup service account. What they did, and this is brilliant, is they wipe out your backup server. And so they say, okay, I'm going to wipe out your backup server so you cannot restore stuff so you can pay us some money. We found out with my team that was looking at our assets that all of our stuff on tape was there, and it was air-gapped, and we had copies of it off-site. And so, we practice what we preach at Spectra Logic, and we do use our products to store and back up our data. And so the way we were using them, we got to the point where we said, okay, here's our silver bullet. We still have all of our data from a few days ago from a backup. Now we can start making some decisions about, what we want to do. We looked at our data and figured out that we have about 30-day recovery to rebuild our systems, bring it back from tape. It's going to be a 4 to 6 week process, going from tape, but we had it. And that gave us the confidence. We also, you know, at the same time, looking at our data, we use our products to also snapshot data on disk. And so now we have another set of immutable data on disk. Obviously, tape was our silver bullet. But this could be faster, you know. So now we're thinking, all right, we're at a place here that we don't have to pay them. We have our data. Yeah, it's painful. Yeah, it's going to take a few days, but we don't have to pay. And obviously, nobody wants to pay $3.5 million to any criminals. So we prevailed. Nathan and I did. It was just Nathan and I. We actually do take all the credit for it. We go and speak about it, and we talk to a lot of people about it, and my team knows that I take all the credit for it, which I was just the ringleader. Other than, you know, a few miscellaneous files that were obviously not important because they weren't on our backups or we didn't want to bring them back, we restored everything. We paid nothing in ransom. Here's what we figured out. It's not a matter of if, it is a matter of when. And even us, we've recovered from it, we've seen it, we've been through it, we know resources, we've implemented resources. We still think it's gonna happen to us again. I mean, it's just the nature of it. And obviously, you know, it's 2 years later now, I can see the statistics online, I can see how much it's grown, I can see how much money there is in it. It's not going away anytime soon. And in my opinion, it's getting worse because of IoT. You know, obviously there's more endpoints out there for attack vectors. And then my favorite is Explore Air Gap and Mutable Data Storage Protection. That saved our butts. Having that tape as our silver bullet gave us a confidence to say, okay, now we can look at other solutions to help us recover a little bit quicker, but it gave us a confidence to really kind of tell the threat actors, no, we're locking down now and we're not paying anything. And that was a scary day, by the way. So that's our story. I tried to get through it as fast as I can. Thank you.